This is Matthew Kratter from Trade University, and today I want to talk about how Bitcoin Satoshi Vision, BSV, just keeps losing. I also want to talk about how Hodlonaut won his court case, which is very exciting for everyone. But I want to start with the usual disclaimer. This video is my personal opinion only, and I may have gotten many things wrong, so please do your own research and reach your own conclusions. All the citations here are taken from publicly available sources on the internet, and I'm merely compiling them, and I may have made some mistakes in doing this. I'm sure that Craig Wright is a great guy in real life, and I wish him and his supporters well. So let's talk about this Craig Wright and BSV. Once upon a time, there was an Australian guy named Craig Wright who claimed that he was Satoshi and the inventor of Bitcoin. And yet, and this is the really strange thing, he was somehow unable to demonstrate to the world that he was in possession of even a single private key that controlled any of the early Bitcoin addresses. He had a lot of lame excuses, which he presented to the court. Craig Wright tells court that he stomped on the hard drive containing Satoshi wallet keys. And the other strange thing is Craig Wright even had a website that shows you how to sign a Bitcoin message using your private keys to prove cryptographically that you control a Bitcoin address, as we talked about a couple days ago in one of the videos on this channel. But, and here's the website on CoinGeek, and yet somehow he couldn't figure out how to do it himself for the million Satoshi coins that he supposedly controls. He then submitted a list of Bitcoin addresses. I think this was the court case in Florida. And then those very same Bitcoin addresses that Craig Wright claimed to control ended up signing messages, making fun of him and calling him a fraud. And by signing these messages, those people showed that they possessed the private keys for those Bitcoin addresses rather than Craig Wright. So he has a history, in my opinion, of submitting false evidence to courts. And again, that's just my personal opinion. So this is the Craig Wright who created a crypto called BSV, Bitcoin Satoshi Vision, has very little to do with either Bitcoin or anything that Satoshi would have had a vision about. BSV is a fork of Bcash, of BCH, which itself is a fork of BTC, of the real Bitcoin. When I hear BSV, though, all I can think of is banana streak virus, which it also stands for. Now, if we take a look at how BSV has performed against the dollar, it's been losing against the dollar since 2019, as far back as this data goes back, actually since November of 2018, when it forked off of Bcash. And not only has it been losing against the dollar, it's been losing against the real Bitcoin, BTC. So when this chart moves down, that's a sign that BTC is strengthening against BSV. And this has been just a complete collapse, as is visible in the relative market cap. So the market cap of BTC is about $400 billion as we speak. The market cap of Bcash is just a small fraction of that. It's about $2.2 billion. And the market cap of BSV, which is really falling into disuse, is $966 million. So really is the loser of these three coins. And what this demonstrates is that it's very, very difficult to successfully fork Bitcoin. In fact, I don't think it will ever be done again. And even these two cases of Bcash and BSV, they're just tiny fractions of the real Bitcoin's market cap at this point. So then BSV, because of all this neglect, not a lot of people want to mine it. And so it's opened itself up to a number of 51% attacks. This is back in August of 2021. And then most recently this week, it's been suffering an empty block attack where you have one miner or one group that controls the majority of the hash rate. And so they're able to mine blocks that are empty, that do not contain any transactions. And this makes it very difficult for people to use BSV now. And if we take a look at the BSV blockchain, we can see these empty blocks. So for example, here is one from October 18th. We can see it just contains one transaction and the output is 6.25 BSV, which is the miner subsidy in BSV. It's very similar in this way to BTC. The TAL miner, I believe, is controlled by Craig Wright or one of his friends or one of his companies. You can see that whenever they mine a block, they're including thousands and thousands of transactions. I guess the mempool's really backed up. But when the hostile miner mines a block, they don't include any transactions. So this is what a Bitcoin empty block, this is what an empty block attack is happening on BSV. If we look at the hash rate distribution for BSV, we can see that 81% is controlled by an unknown miner or mining group, and then 19% is controlled by tal.com, T-A-A-L.com. It's a little difficult to see here. I believe that is the one that's affiliated with Craig Wright. I may be wrong though, so don't quote me on that. But either way, the way this works is about 80, if you control 80% of the hash rate, about 80% of the blocks you will win. And so this is the empty block attack that's continuing. Now, why is this happening? It's happening because BSV miners and BSV, the crypto, uses SHA-256 proof of work, just like Bitcoin, but there are many, many more Bitcoin miners, and together their hash rate is much, much higher than BSV miners. And again, people can choose. They have these ASICs, they have these machines, they can choose what they want to mine. There are no rules about this. So it just takes a few BTC miners to attack BSV, to cripple it, to do a 51% attack, or in this case, an 80% attack, and to mine empty blocks. Now I'll ask you, is this a coincidence that this is happening, this empty block attack is happening the same week as the Craig Wright Hodlonaut trial in Norway finished up? I honestly don't know. You can draw your own conclusions, but if it is a coincidence, it's a pretty funny coincidence in my opinion. Now, if we compare the two hash rates, and again, we can compare these because they're both running SHA-256, BSV has a hash rate of approximately 594 petahashes per second. And if we convert petahashes or petahashes to exahashes, we get 0.594. And that is how we denominate Bitcoin BTC hash rate in exahashes. So if BSV is at 0.594, Bitcoin itself, the hash rate over the past 2 weeks is 262 exahashes. So that's approximately, 440 times higher. And this is the relative hash rate. And again, a higher hash rate means that the money is more secure. So why would you ever use BSV and store significant amounts of your wealth in there? Not only when it's been losing value against the dollar and against Bitcoin forever, but also because it's really susceptible to attacks by ASIC miners. Now, how is the BSV Association dealing with this? They appear to be dealing with it in the same way that Craig Wright and his friends and BSV deal with everything. Rather than relying on a cryptographic system to enforce the rules, they were relying on the courts. And if you have a feel for Satoshi Nakamoto, if you've read a lot of his posts and his emails and his paper, you realize that this is not someone who is really into the legal system. They wanted to create a cryptographic reality that enforced its own rules. And this gives you another hint, in my opinion, that BSV and Craig Wright might not be Satoshi, because if he is, he's suddenly turned litigious in the last few years. So what they're doing, the BSV Association, and it tells you something that this has even an association, it tells you how centralized it is. They are taking action to contact all relevant exchanges and miners to freeze all block rewards associated with this malicious miner. And this is the only thing it appears that they're able to do, which is to resort to the courts. The frosting on the cake really is that Craig Wright has been losing in court as well. This was put forward as a win by BSV supporters. On August 1st, Craig Wright was awarded just £1 in his lawsuit against Peter McCormick after putting forward deliberately false evidence, according to the court. And now we have the most recent ruling against Craig Wright in this very important case in Norway. And Craig Wright has lost this case as of yesterday. He now needs to pay for Hodlonaut's court costs. There's a couple great memes surrounding this, which I'll link to below. The judge in this case wrote that the evidence presented by Wright's lawyers was not suitable to change the court's prevailing opinion that Craig Wright is not Satoshi Nakamoto. Now, this is something I think we all already knew, because he doesn't seem to be able to move or sign with Satoshi's keys, but we now have a legal precedent which has been set. Now, this whole thing was just about a bunch of tweets that Hodlonaut did. He, in a bunch of tweets in 2019, he called Wright a pathetic scammer, cringe, clearly mentally ill, and repeatedly called him a fraud. And Craig Wright claimed that this somehow hurt his career and he wasn't able to get as much for speaking engagements, etc. So this is what the case was about. I think the judge made the right decision. And I want to thank all of you for helping to support Hodlonaut. I made this video on September 3rd to help raise some money. And this was the donation page. The money went to a fund called OpenSats Legal Defense Fund. And now that Craig Wright is having to pay for Hodlonaut's legal fees, I think the money here will not be used for that case. But this is here to defend Bitcoin Core developers and anyone else who might get sued by people like Craig Wright or get into legal trouble. So they were able to raise quite a bit of money thanks to you. And they raised 71 Bitcoin, which at current rates is approximately $1.3 million plus another $74,000. This money will stay in this legal defense fund and will be used for new cases going forward. So this is a huge victory for Bitcoiners, for BTC, and for free speech. And if you're still someone supporting Craig Wright and BSV, I'd really ask you to look at the evidence, make up your own mind. I think this is a huge blow both to Craig Wright's credibility and to BSV and its future as a cryptocurrency. And all of that is just my personal opinion. If you found this video helpful, be sure to hit that subscribe and like button. Hit the notification bell if you want to be notified when I publish my next video. And let me know your questions and comments in the comment section below. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.